sorry. I don't know what's gotten into me.
It's okay. I didn't think it was gonna happen anyway.
Really? I mean, five a little goose pimple crawling up your body.
I don't know. I guess I'm just preoccupied.
With what?
I don't know.
I think I can fix this.
What are you doing?
Just turning off the video camera.
It was on?
Yeah. You know, I thought we'd spice up our sex life a little bit, you know? Put some adventure into it.
The point of videotaping sex is to get off on the performance, Dave.
What?
It doesn't do any good if I don't know the camera's on. You gotta tell me we're taping, or what's the point?
Sorry.
Great. I got a record of our sleep-inducing sex life.
Come on, Katie. Give me some credit. At least I'm trying.
Yeah, well, maybe you should stop trying so hard.
God knows you have. Sorry.
Don't apologize. It's probably just me.
Where are you going?
I don't know. Just out, I guess.
Is the sex that bad, Katie?
No. I get restless about everything. Come on, let's go to the Grey Dove. They have that Minnesota brew you love. It'll be like old times.
I gotta work in the morning. I gotta do brunch.
Dave, you're a waiter. It's not like I'm asking you to go on a heroin binge.
LA is just such a scene.
What scene? The Grey Dove's just your average seedy bar.
Yeah, but it's seedy in that, like, we're cool because we're seedy, but we're self-aware seedy. It's double negative. I don't want to go.
You never want to go anywhere because of your chronic scene aversion.
Katie, I think L.A. blows. I want to move back.
It's not L.A.
Dog?
So, Jenna's being a real bitch tonight, huh?
Yeah, I guess.
You going home?
Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow.
Just a sec. Could you give Jenna a ride home?
What?
Yeah, can you just tell Jenna you'll give her a ride?
Well, why me?
I gotta talk to Karen.
But you came here with Jenna.
Yeah, and she went all psycho on me. I don't want to be there when she starts in again. Come on, Roar. It's practically on your way. It'll take you 5 minutes, all right? You're a bud.
What is your problem?
Gee, I don't know. Guess I just don't want to get crushed if this thing gives out.
Put on your bike helmet.
Come on, I have an exam tomorrow.
So what's the big deal? Fill in the dots.
It's an essay test.
All right.
Can have your boyfriend back.
That's great, guys. Maybe next year you can graduate to sixth grade humor.
Jenna?
What?
Is this it?
No, it's the next one.
Oh.
No, it's okay. I can walk.
No, it's okay. I can go up.
You don't have to.
No, I know. I'm sorry Doc was such a jerk to you tonight.
It's not your fault.
It's not normally like him to just go off like that with another girl. It's kind of unbelievable. Doc's not usually such a jerk.
Yeah, well, all guys are jerks. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. It's true.
No, but it's not.
It's embarrassing how some guys can be such jerks.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that Doc is so lucky to have someone like you. And then he's just a total jerk to you in front of everyone for no reason.
You think Doc's lucky?
Yeah.
Lucky how?
Well, just because compared to the girls he usually goes for. Or not even to compare, just the way you are. You know what I mean? Like when you laugh. It's,
what?
It's really nice. See?
You're funny.
No, I'm not.
Well, maybe not all guys are jerks.
There's all this blood coming out everywhere.
Doc starts to get like, he's gonna faint from seeing it, and so he runs to the bathroom so she won't see. She's like, let me in, let me in.
Yeah.
And he blocks her out. So, yeah, I guess he's never been very good with girls.
Yeah. What about you? Do you have a girlfriend?
No, not right now.
Why not?
I don't know. I don't know who to ask or what to do, you know?
You don't know what to do?
Well, no, of course I know what to do. It's just, you have to take a girl out so it's not just like you're hanging out with your friends. You know what I mean?
Sort of.
Well, it takes a night. My friends and we usually go out for pizza, but I don't think you can do that with someone who's like a girl.
You can't?
No, because then it's just the same thing.
And you think it should be different?
Yeah, I think it has to be different, don't you?
I guess.
Well, I just think that when you go out with someone, it should be like you really thought about what you're going to do, and it's not just some spur of the moment or whatever. I mean, anybody can go out for pizza.
Uh-huh. Well, I should go in.
Hold on.
It's stuck.
Did you push?
I think.
Well, it's tricky. You have to twist it.
I tried.
Let me see.
It's not. It's stuck.
No, there's a trick to it.
God.
No, it's okay. I got it.
It's stuck.
Them.
Come again?
You drunk?
Yeah. Still a little buzzed.
Where were you?
I was at the Dove.
You went to that bar alone?
Well, I knew people.
Really?
Yeah.
Who?
I knew the bartender.
The lip ring guy.
His name's Ollie.
Any guy who gets a lip ring is known as the lip ring guy to me.
I mean, doesn't that make you just a little bit curious? I mean, not the rings, but like somebody that would actually do that to themselves?
Repulsed, yes. Intrigued, no.
What if I said that I was considering getting a nipple ring?
You gotta work up to that. You know, maybe like start with the ears and the nose and then the nipple. Oh, no.
You're so horny. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, it's Ollie. Let me in.
It's Ollie.
It's 2 o'clock in the morning.
Well, we got to talking, and well, he said he got off at 2, so I gave him our address.
You ever heard of just tipping?
Hang on, Ollie.
Lady.
Hang on.
It's kind of nippy. Can you let me in?
Hi.
Hey.
Oh, you remember
Sunday,
right?
What's up, bro?
have a little bit of girl fun.
I can't. I have a presentation to give in class tomorrow on Greek mythology.
Oh, come on. Those guys are all dead anyway. What's the rush? Come on. Let's play a game.
I don't have any time.
Okay, fine. I'll just sit here and give myself a very painful, very loud bikini wax.
All right.
It's called I Never. One person says something that they've never done, and if the other person has done it, she gets a point. Whoever has the most points at the end loses.
Like, I've never been in New York.
Right. See, and I have. So, I get a point. Okay, I've never had sex with two guys at once.
Gee, let me think about that. Junior high, high school. Nope. Okay, my turn. Let's see. I've never been to Montreal.
Come on, it needs to be something juicy, like I've never fantasized about my father and me doing it.
So by juicy, you mean something sick and twisted and indicating serious need of a shrink?
No, I mean something about sex.
Okay. Fine. Let's see. I've never masturbated.
What do you mean?
I've never masturbated. You know, let my fingers do the walking.
Wow, my fingers have run like a 10K marathon.
Go on, it's your turn.
Hang on a sec. Really, you've never done it?
Uh-huh. I mean, it's not something that comes up, you know? Like, do laundry, get milk, diddle myself.
You've had sex, right?
Yeah.
Did you have an orgasm?
Of course I did.
How do you know?
Because I was there. You know what? Screw this game. I'm going to bed.
What did it feel like?
Look, don't you think that's a little personal? I mean, what would you say if I asked you to describe how it felt when you had an orgasm?
I'd tell you.
All right. What'd it feel like?
Well, first of all, it's none of that sappy romance novel blossoming from the flower of my womanhood crap. It just gets so intense until I lose complete control of my body and feel like I'm being shot out of a cannon by
my... I get it. I get it.
After that, I usually want a pizza.
Wow.
So is that what it's like for you, too?
Except for the being shot out of the cannon part. Well, pretty much nothing like that except for the pizza part. Oh my God. I've never had an orgasm.
Why is my toothbrush wet?
You're the scholar, you tell me.
It's not for me. I have not used it since this morning, and I always dry it off with a paper towel.
You have real problems, you know that?
I am serious. It's soaking wet. Somebody used my toothbrush.
Eric was over this afternoon.
I'm gonna have to add $250 to your phone bill.
Relax. We're friends now, remember?
We are not friends. We're the housing department's idea of a sick joke.
How can you say that after tonight?
It's not like we made love. We played a stupid game.
Well, I think of you as a friend. I feel like we had a breakthrough tonight. Here, I got you a present. I think it'll make up for the tragic loss of your toothbrush.
Seven-inch turbo pleasure, pal.
There's an 8 and a 9-inch, too, but I thought you should have something to work up towards.
A personal massager.
It's a vibrator to, you know, help with your problem.
I don't have a problem. You do. You're a nympho pervert freak. How does it work?
Well, first you have to take it out of the box, otherwise you might hurt yourself on the sharp corners. Voila. Instant orgasm.
Sexy. Like a defective flashlight.
It's not about how it looks. It's about how it feels. Unless you turn it on, you're not going to get the full effect.
I guess I won't be getting the full effect then, will I?
It's perfectly safe. Think of it as an educational tool. That's how I learned when I was six.
What? Dress Santa for 10 inches of plastic pleasure?
Not with a vibrator. With the jacuzzi at camp.
Wow. All we did was make leather wallets.
Those water jets, they made me feel like experimenting.
Okay. Going to bed.
I'll leave you two alone.
Not gonna use it, Kiki. I mean, maybe it's a neck massager, but that's it.
Fine, suit yourself. But I'm sleeping at Eric's tonight if you change your mind. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Not possible.
Is it?
I think my foot's asleep.
Do you need to move?
Yeah. Let me. Can I ask you?
What?
Nothing. I was just wondering. I was wondering, and it doesn't matter. I mean, you can say no. Can I? Would you like to go out with me sometime?
Okay.
Dude, cutting you off out of discussion.
What did he do?
He ordered a seltzer. Bradley didn't want to go back home to his wife and kids. Oh, man, that's it for me. You know, I gotta work early in the morning.
Oh, maybe I can come by. You can hook me up with some free grind.
For you? Sure. Now I'll get you back with some free cocktails. Sure. Are you coming to bed?
I'm just gonna finish my beer.
Well,
that bra.
Yeah.
Okay. Night.
Night. So, how long you been shacking together?
About 6 months. Yeah, we moved here after school. You live with anybody?
No, I'm not ready for that hardcore stuff.
I know, yeah. It is pretty hardcore.
Hey, you guys keep the door open when you go to the bathroom?
Huh?
No, I just don't know if I could do that, even if I love someone.
Tell me about your rings.
Yeah?
Yeah. And does it hurt?
No. Well, not as much as my other one.
You mean you pierced your... Wait, were you drunk?
No, you don't get the full experience.
Really?
Oh, are you kidding? I was tanked.
Whoa! I was gonna say.
We've been boozing it up all day at the beach, right? About 4 o'clock, Ray pulls out a 20. He's like, this girl was the first fool who pierces his knob.
His knob?
Yeah, we were pretty loose, right? Anyways, Ronnie pulls out a 20. Then Toad. Then it's down to me and Alex. We gave each other like a good minute, stared out. Then Alex pulls out a Jackson and says, you're on, brother!
No!
Really?
I want to see it.
It? Serious?
Yeah.
All right. I'll let you do the honors then.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. You don't have them.
I made you look.
Was any of that story true?
I think I know a guy named Toad.
Uh-huh.
Next time on Undressed.
What are you guys doing in here?
Well, Dave.
Just get out.
You didn't actually break up with him, did you?
Not those exact words.
I'm just obsessing over this whole love thing.
If you don't love him, what does it really matter if he doesn't love you?
Well, that's the thing. How do I know?